Welcome back to Destination Virginia. We're in Northern Virginia, and Karen, we're on the last leg of our history tour. We've gone from military
to women's history, and now we're at a location that brings it all together. This place celebrates our nation's founding father. We're at George Washington's Mount Vernon.
And we got a chance to talk to Kathy Parkinson, a history interpreter here at Mount Vernon. So we're just outside the doors of the Revolutionary War Theater, so you may hear some bombs going off in front of us here as we talk to Kathy, who is a historical interpreter. And Kathy, I'd never heard that term before, so please tell me, what is a historical interpreter?
Basically, when you come to Mount Vernon, my job is for you to learn things through the information, but also become attached to this national resource, this national treasure of George Washington's Mount Vernon.
It's such an awesome place. And let's start off with, what is Mount Vernon?
Mount Vernon is an amazing place. It's one of the most popular historic houses, you know, in the country. People, after Washington died, it's been a perpetual pilgrimage to visit his tomb. And it's something you physically can't describe. You have to come.
While I've been here, I've learned a little known fact about some women that were integral in the history of Mount Vernon. Tell me about that.
So basically, Washington has no biological kids, right? Martha's a widow with two kids. They raise them and a couple of the stepkids. When both Washington and Martha die, since there's no lineage for George Washington, the estate is handed down through three generations of nephews. And it's the great-grandnephew, John Augustine Washington III, who is the last one to have it. So basically, it's 1853, and he can't afford to take care of it. It is falling apart. And, you know, he has a great idea to sell it to the federal government, the first president of the United States, his estate, his tomb, his remains. And the federal government is basically thanks, but no thanks. I mean, you have to, I know. Things are different. You know, the Civil War is brewing. The word preservation in 1853 has no meaning. You probably can go through a whole laundry list. So he tries to, you know, get the state of Virginia, and they pass on it too. So basically, yeah, it's a handful of women from across the country. The founder is Ann Pamela Cunningham, a 37-year-old woman, who decides, oh, this might be important, right? And so she dedicates her life to saving this place. So basically, it's gonna take the women about 5 years to raise the money, $200,000 back then. So about $6,300,000 in today's cash. Try a fundraiser for that, right?
Wow, that makes sense.
Right.
Besides the awesome Mount Vernon itself, what are some of the other things that you can do here at Mount Vernon?
Well, as you talked about, the Revolutionary War Theater,
yes.
Which is a 40 movie, as you hear the bombs bursting, it's really amazing. So you have the Education Center, the museum, and then for folks who've been to Mount Vernon and want more, there are specialty tours. The tour I like, that I give, is Surviving the 18th Century. And yeah, so basically it's based off of questions we get a lot here at Mount Vernon. Where are the bathrooms as far as in the mansion? Did people bathe back then? And if so, how? And then also they're intrigued by the beds because the beds look short, but they're not. They are all 6 foot except the general's. His is bigger because he was a big guy. He's almost 6'3". So Martha has that bed made especially long. And that is the bed he died in. I mean, that is the bed he died in.
Wow. And how did George Washington die?
It's pretty rough. You think about the French and Indian War, and he has a couple horses shot from under him and four bullet holes in his jacket. But General Washington will get a throat infection, and it's going to take a day and a half. Slowly, it's going to cut off his airways, and he will suffocate. He was 67, and
wow.
It's rough.
That's
really, really rough.
Well, gosh, you are such a fountain of information. I want to talk so much more. We're a little short on time, but thank you so much.
Oh, my pleasure.
Yes,
my honor.
Love your passion.
That was fantastic. Kathy knows so much about George Washington and the history of Mount Vernon and the ladies involved.
Oh, she was incredible. But sadly, Karen, we're at the end of our historical tour here in Northern Virginia.
I know, but we've learned so much from women's rights to aviation history and military history, and that's just scratching the surface of this area.
It sure is, and no matter what type of history you're into, come tour here in Northern Virginia. If you'd like to be featured on an upcoming episode of Destination Virginia, get in touch with us and like us on Facebook.
And don't forget to make Virginia your next destination.
so much cool information here.
I was not laughing.
I was.
Denny, everywhere I look, I see either a giant plane that used to, they called that the Concorde. His
yes.
tie was just a little crooked. It just bothered me a little bit. Okay, sorry, take two.
Sorry, stop.
From the military.
To women's rights, we'll take a walk through town.
Wow.